Hello, today I'm here with a new video and today I'm going to answer your questions. I asked both on my Instagram and also I made a short little video and there you could ask me questions. I got some questions and I've tried to film this video already once and half of the time I was not in focus. So that's why it has taken a little while before it's coming. And now I have wrote down all the questions on papers because I had them on my phone and it was so hard because I want to do like sections of questions. And now I babble too much. So I can leave down in the description. I have three categories: travel, YouTube and makeup, and personal questions. So I can leave the times for them. So if you don't want to see everything. So I'm going to start with travel. And I have to read. If you could jump on a plane with all expenses paid tomorrow, where would you go and why? And this was such a hard question. I think I would say US. Because me and my boyfriend, we want to go to the US. And we want to go and do like the whole of the US. We want to go like to New York and to Florida, to Texas, to Las Vegas, to San Francisco, to Hawaii. I also think I want to go to like Alaska. Did I say Alaska? So we need a lot of money and a lot of time. So if somebody was like, I pay for a trip wherever you want and for how long you want, I would say like a road trip through the US. We are going to do it, but it's going to not be this year, not next year, and not the year after that, I think. But that is something I really want to do. So if somebody would pay me, I would do it. Next question. Do you enjoy travel? And yes and no. I don't like to fly, and I like to be home. I love to be home, and we have two cats, and every time we are on a holiday I miss my cats because I'm a crazy cat lady. So yes and no. I don't like the travel part. So I don't like to go to the airport, go on the plane, the flight, and then go from the airport to the hotel and all that stuff. But else I like to be on a holiday. But I don't like the travel part, but I like to be on a vacation. Travel and vacation. I hope you get what I mean. How often do you travel versus want to? And me and my boyfriend, we are trying to travel once a year outside of Sweden, and we have done it 3 years now, and I'm okay with that. I don't need more. This year I think I'm maybe going to travel twice. I'm going with my mother and my brother, and me and my boyfriend also thinking of doing one over out of Sweden travel. And so yeah, mostly once a year, and I don't need more than that. Next question. Where have you been? And when I was little, we traveled to the US twice and also to Spain. We drove from Sweden to Spain. I don't remember anything of that drive. And I don't remember so much of the US trips either. But then the trips I do remember, I have been to Greece, Lanzarote, I don't know if it's that's the English name, and Paris, France, Switzerland, Great Britain. I have been to London twice. I've also been to Germany, and then we were in Berlin, and also Iceland, Reykjavik. And then I have also been to Copenhagen. Denmark. I always forget that like Copenhagen is not a part of Sweden in some way. Because we can take the train to Copenhagen, it take like 2.5 hours. And it's like I forgot that I am out of Sweden when I go to Copenhagen. I don't know if it is because I understand what they are saying, and it's like Sweden and Denmark is pretty similar. So yeah, I think that's all the countries I've been to. Okay, and then the last question. Rebecca, you asked like a lot of questions in one question, so I hope you will be satisfied with my answer. So, do I like long travels? No, because I don't want to be away from home too much. I think 2 weeks is my limit. Longer than that, I just want to go home, sleep in my own bed, eat my own food, do my own things. So, not so long travels. And do I like hot or cold weather? And when we were on Iceland last year, it was the highest temperature, I think it was 17 or 20 degrees. Perfect for me. I hate warm weather. Last summer, or this summer in Sweden, was awful to me. For me, it was so freaking hot. I was so glad that I was at work most of the part, because I hate warm weather. I can't be in the sun because I get burnt so easy, so I have like SPF 50 all the time. I don't like to sweat, I don't like warm weather, I don't like to lie in the sun, so not a hot vacation. No. Not like a sun vacation in that. But I also don't want it to be cold, I want it to be in between. And do I like mountains or oceans? And one part of me is like, oh, I want to hike. And I don't know why. I have never been hiking. I don't think I would like it. But one part of me is like, I want to go on a hike. I want to climb a mountain. But I like the ocean as well. So I don't know. Maybe I have to say ocean. And I am so sorry if this is a messy video. I hope it's okay. So now we're going to makeup and YouTube questions, and this, I got some questions in Swedish and my translation, I'm not so good at that maybe, so I think I've translated this in something that's okay. What do you think about the makeup market with the makeup market in Sweden versus other countries? And that's a little bit hard to answer because I mostly buy my makeup online, and but okay, I think like this. In Sweden, Sweden's makeup market, the big typical makeup market, is very bleh. It's like brown, black, and a little bit of orange. It's pretty boring. It's not colorful palettes. I don't think I can. Okay, I can, but it's like the only colorful brand we have in stores in Sweden is like NYX. We have Urban Decay as well, but they don't do so much colorful makeup. And Anastasia Beverly Hills, of course. But we don't have like this crazy, colorful, fun things. They are brands that have, but no brand in Sweden has like their thing is colorful. And also in Sweden we have only like the big brands, and there is not so much in brands. Like Linda Hallberg is an in brand, but more than that we don't have in brands. So I think that's a little bit boring about Sweden. But I have not been in, I've been in London shop makeup, but that was before I started my makeup thing. But I think like in Europe, it's almost the same thing in all the European countries. But I think the US seems so much more fun, because you have Ulta and stuff like that. But it's hard for me to compare them to because I haven't been on a makeup journey sometime. Makeup journey. No, that's not right. I have not been on a vacation for buying makeup, so I don't really know how to answer this, except that I think Sweden is pretty boring when it comes to makeup and other countries seems more fun. And to take in consideration is that Sweden is not such a big country, so maybe a brand can't like niche super colorful things because it's not so many people that will buy them in Sweden because we are not that many people. What makeup looks do you prefer? I nowadays I like the colorful, and I start to like the more shimmer ones. Before I was all in the mattes, but I like shimmer, I like colorful, but I also like a little bit darker. Now that I say with like purple and yellow eye, no, pink and yellow eye. But I think I like a little bit darker. Darker and warmer. Do you get what I mean? A little bit of shimmer. But I like the most makeup, so but the makeup look I prefer is something warm, maybe a little bit darker and orange. Your best foundation, and I think it's this one. This is Lumiene's Blur foundation. I haven't used it for a long time because I have other foundations, but I think this is my top foundation ever. I only wish that it was light enough for me. I have to blend this out, but this is so good. It lays on top on your skin so good. It's blurring, it's a little bit shimmer. I love, love, love this foundation, so I think this is the best foundation I have ever tried. If you could choose one color as your eyeshadow, which one would you choose? And I would choose orange. Maybe a little more reddish orange than bright orange. So more reddish orange, like a little rusty, if I can only choose one, because it's so good. And then we're coming to more YouTube questions. And what's your subscriber goal? And I don't have a subscriber goal. But one thing I would like is to get, I think it's 1,000 subscribers. Then you can use this community tab where you can write some things and your subscriber sees it. I think it's when you come up to 1,000. So I would like to do that because I would like to have that. And yeah, that's all. I didn't start my YouTube channel to get a lot of followers. And I really don't care. If I have, like, say, like now 500 followers, and I have 500 followers that cares about me, I would more appreciate them that say like have 200,000 followers and have like 500 cares. It's not the number that is important, it's the community that we have on my channel that's important to me. And if you are 20 people or if you are 200 people, I don't care. I don't have a goal with subscribers. It would be fun to hit 1,000 so I could have that tab thing, but other than that, I don't really care. I like to get new subscribers, of course, but it's nothing like I think I need them and I really want them. It's not that. Who's your favorite YouTuber? And hard question, I don't know. There is a lot of people that I follow that I watch all the videos they put up. But I don't know who is my favorite. I can leave some links to YouTube channels I really like down in the description. But I don't have a favorite, so I will put them in alphabetic order. So I don't rank them in any way. It will be in alphabetic order. Okay, and this was not a YouTube-related question, but what's your favorite color? When it comes to clothes, I don't know if you have noticed this, but I wear black a lot, like almost every time I wear black. So black is my favorite color when it comes to clothes. I almost only have black clothes, so yeah. And when it comes to eyeshadows, it's orange or yellow. It's a hard pick. Orange or yellow. But other way, in my all day-to-day life, it's black. I have a black car. I almost use black clothes. My favorite shoes are black. All my bags are black, almost. So yeah, black, black, black. And now we're going into the personal questions. And I got two questions. That was, what do you work with? And I work in a warehouse, and I am a consignee. I am, I hope I pronounced that right. So I register all the things that come into the warehouse into our computer system easily, and then I do some other things, but that's what I'm doing for a living. I work full-time 5 days a week, Monday to Friday, and yeah. And then this question I also got two times: what do you do when you're not filming YouTube, or what do I do outside my YouTube life? And the most part of it is I watch YouTube. And now when I'm trying to have 4 videos up a week, I film a lot and I also editing a lot. So that's the most thing that I do. And me and my boyfriend, we love to watch TV shows together. So we watch a lot. Right now we are watching Parks and Recreations. I like it. And yeah, that's what we do most of the time. And now we're going into the hard questions. I don't know if I can answer them, but I will try. How life is in my city, your city in Sweden? And I live in a summer city. This is, in the summer, it's a lot of tourists here because I live by the ocean in Sweden. And the thing Swedes love the most is the ocean, apparently. And it's I live in a pretty small town. It's not a big town, but it's not a super small town. It's a normal town. The thing I like about it, except in the summer, it's a very... it's not so stressful, this town. It's a very easygoing town, and I like it. And I think it's the right size, and it's pretty close to Gothenburg, and also to Malmö, and also to Copenhagen. So I like that. I don't want to live in a super big city because I don't want to be stressed when I'm going out to the city. So yeah, I hope that's a good answer, but it's a pretty chill little city. People not so stressed, and yeah. Where do you see yourself in 5 years from now? And I have always hated these questions because I have had anxiety for like more than 10 years of my life. But now it's getting better, and now I'm okay with this question, but I don't really know where I see myself. I want to buy a house, and I want to buy one more cat. And I hope that I feel better within myself. Other than that, I don't know. I don't want kids. So I see myself as not a mom, more than to my cats in 5 years. But I see myself in a house, have a new car. I really want to buy a new car. And yeah. Okay, next question. If you could change one life decision you have made, what would it be? And when I was thinking about what to answer on this one, I haven't done so many big life decisions. One was to move down here that I live now. I didn't do it. I wasn't born here. Not born and raised here. I moved down because my boyfriend lives here. And I think that's my biggest life decision ever. And I do not regret it. So I don't think I have done a life decision, because where I am now in life, I am pretty satisfied with where I am. So everything that I have done has led up to this. So I don't want to change anything. So no. If money wasn't an issue, would you move and live somewhere else? And I think not. I think I like it in Sweden. I know how things goes. I know how you live in Sweden, if you can say it like that. And I don't think I want to move somewhere else. I feel at home in Sweden. And what is your favorite part about living in Sweden? And I'm going to sound like a super old woman. I like the seasons. We have 4 seasons in Sweden. Spring, summer, autumn and winter. Everyone has that. And I like that we can have like so much snow and so cold weather, but we can also have it so hot. I like the seasons change that we have in Sweden. I would not want to live in a country where it's summer all year round. I do not want that because I don't like summer that much. So I love that about living in Sweden, that we have 4 different seasons and they are big difference in between the seasons. And also one thing that I love about Sweden, in the summer, like 1 week in the summer, it's light the whole day. It's never get dark. Love it. Love it. Okay, we have some questions left, so I'm trying to speed this up. What size are your plugs? And I have 20 millimeters. What it is in US measurements, I don't understand what the US is doing with their measurements on earplugs, because it's so crazy. So I'm going to write it here. But I got 20 millimeters. I have had it for like, maybe it's 3 years now. I don't really know. No, maybe 2. And also, where do I buy my plugs? And I buy almost all my plugs on Crazy Factory. These I have bought on Crazy Factory. It's German site. I really love it. And I don't want to spend so much money on my plugs. I don't know why. But these are my super favorite plugs. I have them almost every day, as you can see. And these are stone plugs. And stone is the best for my ear. Stone or glass. I can't wear wood. It dries my ears out. So yeah. And now my battery is blinking. This is going super great. And do you dream in English? And no, I do not. I don't think in English either. So maybe that's why I'm not talking so good English, because when I talk, I have to translate it in my head. So no, I do not dream in English. Have you or do you want to play with fun hair colors as you do with eyeshadows, or get some fun wigs? So no commitment. And I've dyed my hair black once. Total disaster. I dyed half my hair black and kept the other half blonde. Not a good decision. It was so hard to make it, to put in more color, so I colored my whole hair black. Looked awful. I bleached it. It turned orange. So no. And then I have used some color bombs. I can use them on my hair because I have so light hair color, so I can use them and have color for like 2-3 weeks and then it washed out. And then I have tried red, purple and pink, but I would like to color my hair in some fun color, but also not. So maybe wigs would be an idea for me, just to try it. But I don't know. Maybe wigs. I don't know. Okay, now we have 2 questions left. What other forms of art excite you, either as an artist or experience? And I do not good at anything with painting or anything like that. I'm so crappy at that. I have crappy handwriting as well. And I don't know if I like art. I wouldn't say that I do. No. I like music, but not like this classical music, so maybe that's an art form I like, but nothing more than that. I don't like to go on museum that much. Maybe to see like creepy things. I like creepy things, and that is not an art form, but I like creepy things. Okay, and the last question. Tell us more about your pets. And we have two cats, and now you can hear my boyfriend out in the kitchen, but we have to live with it. So we have two cats. We have Elsa and Bodil. And I can put pictures of them here. And we can start with Elsa. She is the typical cat. She runs this household, if you ask her. We do whatever she wants. We don't decide anything. We give her food. We pet her when she wants. She do everything else. And she also a pretty smart cat. So she do some things that she's not allowed to. And then we have the other cat. And this is the other cat. This is our little baby cat. She's more like a dog than a cat. She is around us. Every time she follows us around, she sleeps with us every night. She comes when you call on her. And yeah, she's the little crazy one. And also she acts like a kitten even though she's soon 8 years old. So this is Bodil. And this is our baby. I am a crazy cat lady, yes. So yeah, that was all the questions, and I really hope you liked this video. It became super long, but I really hope you like it, and now my battery's blinking as fudge. So yeah, I hope I got all the questions, and if you want to ask me something else, just ask me and I will try to answer them. And yeah, I hope you liked this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!